Nagbabalik ang BRGY. And you're still with me, your boy next boy Fee, and our G Pinoy na si Joseph. Ngayon na nasa France. So si Joseph, of course, kanina pinag-usapan natin his whole journey from his childhood, kung paano niya na-develop yung career niya sa Singapore, and now talagang tinuloy-tuloy niya na ang career niya dito naman sa France. So kanina nga, you mentioned that you're also into writing songs and poetry as well. So how do you balance this craft with the many, many things you are already doing?
So after work, normally I go to a place where I can do spoken word and perform in front of, you know, French people, a very international group of people as well. So normally I do that after work. And then on the weekends, yun nga, si Pinoy Jam Paris, I spend a lot of time helping Pinoy Jam.
Pero yun nga, you talked about poetry. And when it comes to poetry naman, parang kailan ka nag-start magkahilig sa pagsulat sa mga ganito?
Nag-start yun, actually high school pa ako. Parang for some reason, I just am, parang nagsusulat lang ako. For some reason, hindi ko rin talaga alam kung bakit.
And pag nagsusulat ka ba, one of the reasons is to really help out Pinoys as well. May ganung ano ka ba? Like, sinasama mo ba siya ng Pinoy culture?
Parang gusto ko pa talagang i-uplift yung Filipino culture through my writing, and parang ipakita pa sa mundo na marami pa ibang kayang gawin yung mga Pilipino.
It's great to see and hear your stories na ganyan, na kumbaga mas nako-cultivate mo siya and mas napopromote mo siya. Not just in the Philippines, of course, even abroad sa France or whether it's in Singapore even. Pero ang dami na natin pinag-uusapan tungkol sa craft mo. Baka naman pwede tayo makarinig ng mga sample natin dyan sa mga compositions mo. Ano, let's start siguro with one of your songs, kung okay lang.
This is a story of a woman, a legend born, abandoned by her parents but then defied the norm. At a young age, she's forced into marriage, but later fell in love with a guy full of courage. Together, they led the people to fight the oppression and paved the way to decolonization. But her new husband was assassinated by none other than Miguel, their best friend, paid by the Spanish to betray them. So she took the bolo and the horse, rode up to Tayum in the north. There she united people on horseback. She became their general and forced an attack. She's riding hard, she's taking charge. She's the mother of the first revolution. She fought for the people to free her nation. Now every woman knows her name. Now every man knows her name. She's Gabriela Silang.
Ang ganda nun! All the research for that, grabe. Tsaka ano ah, the way you say it, may laman. Parang madadala mo talaga yung audience mo while you were singing that as well. Ang galing. And we mentioned na nagpo-poetry ka rin as well. So, eto na, last na talaga. May hihirit ako ulit when it comes to this one. Baka naman, poetry naman.
So, lift your head up. When you try to save the friendship, even though there's no longer any receipts of reciprocated love. When you've been fully gaslighted, and you were left with nothing but the ashes of your self-confidence, and the only thing that will save you from choking from the branches of the past that's still burning in your memories is actually the burning of all the remnants of your past. Lift your head up when they, your ex, have completely transcended like an angel of success that gives inadequate financial tips on TikTok, trending and rising above and beyond every type of ex or partner or lover that you've ever had. The kind of ex that you've already blocked from email, WhatsApp, Telegram, Discord, Facebook, TikTok, BeReal, Insta, Snapchat, Reddit, Twitter, Airbnb, Homeroom, and LinkedIn, but you kept their cell phone number just in case. Lift your head up.
May hugot ka ba, Joseph? Based on personal experience ba ito pag nagsusulat ka?
Ano yan? About an ex, but not for my ex.
Ah, okay. So, may friend ka ba na nagkwento about this one? Or is it more of just your imagination when nagsusulat ka?
Ano siya? Parang mix siya ng personal experience plus imagination moments.
Grabe. Gusto ko yung ano eh, parang on-trend ka pa rin eh. Nababanggit mo pa rin yung TikTok, Discord, so many other apps as well. Pero ang phone number talaga namang nanatili dyan, di ba? Just in case. magamit as well. Pero Joseph, again, thank you so much sa pag-share ng talent mo sa story mo. For sure, there are a lot of Filipinos out there who are also dreaming to help out their family na meron din mga challenges the same as you faced before. So just being able to hear your story and how you really transcended with your career ngayon, nakakatuwa and nakaka-inspire. So hopefully, most Pinoys na mas creative pa na, kumbaga, until now, kasi feeling ko na-underestimate pa yung creative side ng mga tao. So, hopefully, mas magamit pa natin yan. Kasi, as kita nyo naman, saan umabot ang creativity ni Joseph? Umabot ng France. So, diba? So, again, Joseph, thank you so much. Saan ka pa ba namin pwedeng mapanood? Yung mga videos mo, baka naka-upload yung mga spoken poetry mo. Go ahead and i-mention mo na yung mga social media.
Thank you again, Jay. And yes, my name is Joseph Turrios. Please follow me on Instagram at jotsjots, J-O-T-S. Just slide me a DM. I'll send you the other stuff as well.
Thank you so much. And B-Fam, hopefully na-inspire kayo kay Joseph. Pero mukhang may inspire pa tayo later on. Dahil sa ating pagbabalik, may isang certified dreamer, G Pinoy pa tayo makikilala. And I've heard hindi raw naging madali ang journey niya in reaching her dreams. Nako, alamin natin yan sa pagbabalik ng BRGY.
Hi, BFAM. I'm Clara Benin. And if there's something I want that's free to all, it would be coffee. Because I love coffee and it's an essential for me, so I think it should be free for everyone.